สวัสดีครับ Good morning once again กสิทธิ์พิรมย์ from Bangkok Today is the 5th Monday August 2019 I was not able to have a chat with all of you during the weekend as I had to be up in Chiang Mai province to be a panelist organized by the Future of Thailand Party, one of the main opposition parties in the current parliament. The subject matter for the seminar in Chiang Mai as of yesterday on Sunday, the 4th of August, was about the amending or the writing of a new constitution as it is deemed that the current constitution promulgated 2 years ago after the referendum has made Thailand a quasi-democratic regime, more of a democratic bureaucratic regime with bureaucrats, especially military officers, having political role in the affairs of the state. And for any democratic country, you cannot call oneself a democratic country if military officers are directly involved in politics. So in that sense, there's a need for the Thai society to have a new constitution or to amend the present constitution drastically. My point of view delivered at the Sunday seminar as of yesterday was that I do not believe that the present government of Thailand under General Prayut Chan-o-cha will have the seriousness or the sense of purpose or the earnestness to really change the constitution to make it more democratic, because this current constitution was more or less being drafted and approved by the military junta that was ruling Thailand for the past 5 years, and they have been benefiting from the present constitution. They are in control of the political life and processes of Thailand. So in that sense, why should they amend or change the constitution? It would be detrimental to their own vested interest. So at the panel, as of yesterday, I said there is no point in trying to push or to urge the government of General Prayut Chan-o-cha to have the intention, the goodwill, or even the integrity to amend the constitution to make it more democratic. So I think the task falls on the shoulders of ordinary people of all walks of life. The ordinary citizens of Thailand would have to get together, work and come out with a new draft constitution, a democratic one, which means that there would not be any room for any bureaucrats or military officers to be part and parcel of the political life of Thailand in the years to come. But leave that constitutional drafting and amendment aside. What I would like to speak to all of you today is about an NGO or a civil society organization that has been in existence for almost 4 decades and has been quite instrumental in pushing for democratic awareness and participation. It was also active in the drafting of the 1997 constitution, which was being slated to be the most democratic, and it was the people initiative. But that is already history. But this particular NGO, the English name is Campaign for Popular Democracy. In the Thai language, it is called Kana Kamakan Patirup Phuea Pracha Phuea Kana Kamakan Ronarong Phuea Prachathipatai, more or less the a committee of the people, ordinary people, to advocate a more democratic regime of the Thai society. And for the past almost a year, this particular NGO has held a series of meetings with its own members, as well as in networking with almost two dozen fellow NGOs to come out with a set of wish lists or proposals to the public at large and to the government of General Prayut Chan-o-cha. And this wish list with specific requirements were being announced to the public about a week ago. And I would like to take this opportunity to summarize some of the important points. There were 11 points altogether. The first one is the call for the reform of the present cabinet. As I did mention last week, that the composition of cabinet was a big disappointment to the Thai society and to the people at large, because the cabinet members are old-time politicians. Many of them have a grayish record. So it was a big surprise and a big disappointment that General Prayut Chan-o-cha has brought a few of these grayish politicians into the cabinet. So the question of good governance becomes the issue, whether this particular cabinet can really serve the country for the interest of the common good, or they would continue to play the old politics of rent-seeking, doing things for their own benefit, vested interest, and so on. So the committee, or the campaign committee for democracy, has directly asked General Prayut Chan-o-cha to reform the cabinet as soon as possible to make it more credible and more trustful. That was the first point. The second one is that the campaign democracy committee has asked for a comprehensive political reform of Thailand, namely a more participatory political life. And next to that is the question of decentralization of the administrative structure of Thailand. And the most, one of the most important calling to the General Prayut government is to have the rest of the other 76 provinces of Thailand to have the election of the governor, instead of having the governor coming from the Ministry of Interior. The more that we can have elections at the local level, the more democratic we become, the more participatory politics could be in the making. The other one was to ask the General Prayut government to observe human rights by every cabinet members and senior officials of the whole Thai bureaucracy, that they have to respect human rights. There should not be forced abduction, unfair judicial processes, and so on, corruption into the judicial regime altogether at the police level, at the Office of Attorney General, or even at the among the judges themselves. So, and then people should have the assistance when they have to go to the court and they do not have the money to afford the court cases and so on. It is incumbent on the government or the state to help the people to be able to fight for their own justices and so on. The other point that the campaign for democracy advocacy has asked and requested the government is to have a government that function with the principle of good governance, anti-corruption, and to make public procurement more transparent and accountable. And there has been a suggestion that the government should set up a central body to do all the public procurements, so that there will be a sort of a definite system and people can access to information. The business company can bid for projects and programs and so on in a very transparent manner. Then the Campaign for Democracy Advocacy also urged the government to do a drastic reform of the education system of Thailand, to decentralize education in Thailand, to allow the local governments to have more responsibility. The other point that the Committee on Campaign for Democracy Advocacy has asked is for the present government of General Prayuth Chan Ocha to review all the laws, and especially the orders and the decrees issued by the past military governments of the past 5 years. Because a lot of decrees and orders by the military junta have infringed upon the basic human rights of the people. And some of the decrees and orders and so on give too much power to the soldiers, to the police, to the civilian bureaucrats over the human rights and the basic protection of the human rights of the people, especially giving a sort of a blank check, free hand for state authorities to go into a house to search and so on without proper evidence and warrant from the court of justice. So there must be, for Thailand to move forward as a democratic country, existing laws, recent orders and decrees by the military junta should be done away with, including the decrees and the cabinet decision that were done without proper preparation, without feasibility studies, especially the so-called industrial estate. And the biggest one is the EEC, the Eastern Economic Corridor, that created a sort of a body, a state within a state with so much authorities to do so many things that do not have to observe the environmental rules, the health rule, and so on, and could move the people out in order to cater to the big businesses and so on. The other point that the Committee for the Campaign of Democracy Advocacy has been pushing is for the government to review the existing economic regime and practices that allow more of the oligarchical or monopolistic practices by the big conglomerates and so on. This not only hurt small and medium-sized company, but it affected the environmental, the community surrounding life and so on. So the point is that the government should not only cater only to the business interests. They have to look at the economic consequences, the social consequences for the small people, fishermen, farmers, livestock raisers, and so on. So there must be a more of a balancing act in order to cater to the interest of every walks of life, to every sector of the economic regime, and so on. Then there should be more of this fairness, fair wage, affordable living for the labor forces of Thailand. They should have the right to assemble, to form union, and they should be treated fairly in a more human manner, and they should be able to have the equality before the law. The other point that the Committee on Campaign for Democracy Advocacy is for the government to work in unison as a team and to really push for the reconciliation in the Thai society, because the political ideology is quite confrontational for the past 15 years. And so far, the military junta of the past 5 years and the present government have not done anything to that effect. I think what we have is restitution justice would be one. Political crimes should be given the amnesty and so on, in order that people can assemble and talk to one another and have a dialogue, but not to spend their life on political and ideological confrontation that might lead to violence and so on unnecessarily. And I think the government is now elected in a viable position to do something about national reconciliation. There has been many reports and findings by the various truth and reconciliation committees of the past. So practically, the government of General Prayut Chan Osha doesn't have to do anything new, just to bring all of those reports onto the table, have a relook at it, and make the decision so that Thailand, the whole society, can reconcile with one another and move forward in a more unison manner. And there is also a call for the government to work as a team in a more integrated manner. And the last point is that the Committee for the Campaign of Democracy Advocacy has asked the government, the whole apparatus and so on, to pledge themselves to make an oath on integrity compact, that is to promise the people and to the society at large that they will work with high ethical and moral standard for the benefit of the country as a whole. So there's a lot for the government of General Prayut Chan Osha to do, a lot on the plate, but everything has to begin with the moral precept, with the integrity in mind, with the principle of only to serve the community, the country at large, and to do away with any vested interest. And the government must be earnest in trying to run the country, push the country forward in a very transparent manner, governed by the good governance principle. And if that were to happen, General Prayut could continue to be Prime Minister for life. But without that, there will be more problems in the Thai society. And in that sense, ordinary people have to work much more, much harder, in order to exert their power for the benefit of themselves and for the country as a whole. So a few points about the wish list of the Committee on Campaign for Democracy Advocacy. Sawasdee krap. Goodbye.